Very good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are doing well. Children, we all know that we all are going through this tough time of pandemic. So I request everyone to be safe and be very careful and stay at home only. Right, children? So I want everybody to take this time as an opportunity to reshape and to make enough space for studies, right, children? And I want everybody joining the online classes from now onwards and make our efforts success, right, children? So let's start. Okay, children, get ready with your reader and a notebook. We are starting with the very first chapter, chapter number one, representation of geographical features. Topographical maps. Now the question is, what are topographical maps? Or what is a topographical map? A topographical map is a large scale map which shows both man-made as well as physical features. Man-made features, for example, malls, buildings, bridges, dams, etc. And your physical features or natural features are forest, river, river drainage system. All these are your natural features or physical features, we can say. So, topographical maps are what? These are large scale maps which show both man-made as well as physical features. Now, what is a large scale map? So a large scale map is what? Large scale map is a map which shows small amount of an area with a greater detail. Right? Okay. Now children, you just follow me and note down in your notebook. Right? Now signs. First sign, let's start with the temple. If you see this type of feature on the topographical map, then this type of feature is what? Is a temple. Right? Now see the second symbol. If you see this type of feature, a dome shape roof, then we called it a mosque. Right? Now the third one. It's a railway track. Next feature is railway track with RS. That means what? Railway station. Fifth one, PO. That's a post office. Number six, PTO. So this one is PTO is post and telegraph office. Number seven, PS. That is police station. Number eight, DB. It's a dark bungalow. Right? Now children, see the importance of colors. Color plays very important role in topographical map, right, children? So color identification is very important, very, very important, I can say. Now see the first one, green color. So green color, if you see green color on topographical map, that means that is forest area, forested area or vegetation, right? Second is yellow color. If you see this type of yellow wash on topographical map, then that signifies what? Agriculture or cultivation. Third, white. If you see white wash there on a topographical map, then that is open scrub. So what is open scrub? That is barren land, infertile land, right? So now next is, if you see this type of feature on the topographical map with blue color, so that is what? Reservoir, right? Now next is this triangle with blue color, tube well. Next, blue dot, that is perennial well. And this blue outline only, that is non-perennial well. So this perennial well, you'll not write only well. What is important here? Whether it is perennial well or non-perennial well, that has to be mentioned. If you see blue dot, then you will mention perennial well. If it is only blue outline, then you will write what? Non-perennial well. So this word perennial and non-perennial, this is very important, right? So you write, if you write only well, you'll not get the marks, right? So what you will write? If it is perennial, you will write perennial well. If it is non-perennial well, you will write non-perennial well. Now, the question is, what is the difference between the perennial well and non-perennial well? Perennial well is what? The well which contains water throughout the year, right? So now, what is non-perennial well? Non-perennial well is that well which contains water during rainy season only, right? During rainy season only. But what is perennial well? The well which contains water throughout the year, right? Now come to the next symbol or color. We can say, if you see this brown line with this digit written on it, then that is what? That is contour height. We'll say contour height. Right? So the first contour height is 200 meter. Here meter is very important. Now second, this brown line, 300 meter is written. This meter is very important. Unit is very important. So contour height of second one is 300 meter. So here I have written meter. Meter unit is must. If you write only contour height, that is okay. But if you don't write contour height with 200 meter or 300 meter, then that will not be a complete answer, right? So you need to write unit in this contour height. Now next is contour interval. So what is contour interval? See here, I've given two contour heights here. One is 500, that is in meter. And second one is 450 meter. One is one contour height is of 500 meter, another one is of 450 meter. Now what is contour interval? So contour interval is what? It's a difference between these two contour heights. So difference means what? Contour interval, 500 minus 450 meter. So if we subtract this 450 from 500, then 50 will come out, and this 50 meter is what? It's a contour interval between this 500 and 450 meter. So this is contour interval, right? This much for today, children. We'll continue with the same chapter with more signs and symbols, right, children? So till then, bye.